This serene tourist spot attracts thousands from across the world. Little a tourist will ever suspect what a shocking past hidden behind this beautiful lake. When in the summer of 1816, the world forgot what warmth felt like. Snow fell in June, rivers froze in July, crops withered under gray skies. It was a summer that never came, and no one knew why. They called it the year without a summer. But the cause of this frozen horror began halfway across the world, with a sound so loud it was heard over 2,000 kilometers away, Mount Tambora, Indonesia. April 10, 1815. One of the most powerful volcanic eruptions in human history. A cataclysm so massive it blew the top off the mountain. Literally. Tens of thousands died instantly from fire, ash, and collapsing villages. But Tambora's true devastation wasn't local. It was global. The volcano spewed over 150 cubic kilometers of ash into the sky, enough to blanket the earth in a choking veil. Sunlight dimmed, the skies turned red and strange, and the climate began to shift. In New England, farmers woke up to snow in June. Frost struck in July. The ground was too cold to grow anything. In Europe, it rained for months. Wheat rotted in the fields. Famine took hold. In Ireland, typhus spread like wildfire. In Switzerland, a young writer named Mary Shelley, trapped indoors by unrelenting storms, wrote a ghost story to pass the time. The result? Frankenstein, born from a world gone cold. For the inquisitive mind, same year bicycle was invented. Globally, over 200,000 people may have died from famine and disease, all sparked by a mountain blowing its top. Tambora was a reminder, a chilling whisper from Earth itself, that we live on a restless planet, and Tambora wasn't the worst it can do, not by far. To understand how bad it can get, we have to go further back, not hundreds of years, but tens of thousands. 74,000 years ago, another volcano in Indonesia awoke, Toba. But this wasn't just an eruption, this was apocalyptic. Toba released more than 2,800 cubic kilometers of ash, dwarfing Tambora. The blast carved out a lake 100 kilometers long. Ash blanketed India. Sulfates blocked the sun. Earth entered a volcanic winter. Temperatures plummeted, glaciers advanced, plants died, and with them, the animals we hunted. Some scientists believe humanity was pushed to the edge, reduced to as few as 3,000 individuals globally, a genetic bottleneck where all modern humans may trace their ancestry to a tiny, isolated group of survivors. We almost didn't make it. Today, we live in cities, drive electric cars, launch rockets into space. But the Earth remembers. And below our feet, pressure builds once more. From Yellowstone to Campi Flegrei, to the sleeping giants in the Pacific Ring of Fire, the potential for another super eruption remains. Not in centuries, maybe decades, maybe less. The year without a summer taught us that even a single eruption can freeze the world. Toba showed us it could almost end it. We are fragile, but we are also survivors. Every storm, every shadow in history, we've endured. When the earth went cold, the year without a summer and the supervolcano that almost wiped us out. The sky darkened once before. It could again, but this time, we know what lies beneath. If this blew your mind, hit that like button. Subscribe for more deep dives into the Earth's hidden stories. And remember, history isn't just in the past, it's beneath your feet. Without knowing past, our future have no perspective.